thank you. We thank you for this opportunity to worship you, God. We're so honored today to be inside your house just one more time. God, we pray, God, that you would have thine own way. God, that you would do what you want to do in this service. God, that you would let your glory fall fresh in this place. God, we're praying in advance, God, for our bishop. God, give him preaching power, God. That give him the anointing, God, that makes preaching easy. God, and I pray in the name of Jesus that you would open up our ears, open up our hearts, God, that we may hear and receive the word on this morning. And God, we're praying for the ones that are here. Praying, God, for the ones who wanted to be here but could not. God, we're praying for the ones who's on their way. God, we give you the glory and we give you the praise and we give you the honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, let's clap our hands and give God some praise. Amen. At this time, Sister Denise is coming to lead us in praise and worship. Come on, let's clap our hands and receive her as she comes.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
It's so special to be here today.
Yes.
Amen. I'm grateful to be alive.
Yes.
Grateful to be among the living. Yes. We're just going to have some old school praise and worship this morning. It's something everybody should know, and if you don't know, you can join in and pick up your fast.
Yes.
Bless that wonderful name of Jesus.
Thank you.
next couple weeks of who will be doing this inspirational message to prepare our hearts and minds for the main course. Amen? But the hair is just like when you go out to eat, you get the little appetizer, and you get a little main course, and you get a little dessert at the end. You know what I'm talking about? So it gives me a great honor and certainly a privilege to present this young man of God who is my brother. Amen. Affectionately, he is my brother. We are so close together in ministry, and I thank God for the spirit and the connection that we both have. He is no stranger here. He's one of our sons and members of the church, and he's here faithfully every Wednesday for a new year. The Lord has his hands on him, and it gives me an honor and a privilege to introduce to some and present to others my brother, Minister Christopher White of the Grace of the Church. Come on, let's thank God as he comes for our inspirational message. Come on, let's clap our hands and let's see him as he comes.
But to minister and give his life a ransom. Amen. Again, the word says, even as the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and give his life a ransom. In New Living Translation or New International Version, it says,
no.
Even as the Son of Man came not to serve, but to serve and to give his life a ransom. So I came today to teach about how to evangelize through serving evangelism. Everybody say servant evangelism.
Servant.
Amen. We know that our bishop has been teaching on the subject of evangelism, and so today he gave me the task to teach about servant evangelism. Now before we get into what servant evangelism is, we must first know what evangelism is itself. Evangelism is proclaiming the gospel or the good news. Amen.
Amen.
And when asking most what evangelism is, we get that short answer, that evangelism is just proclaiming the good news. But good news can be anything. Amen?
Amen.
Good news could be that I just got a new car. Amen? That's good news. Good news can be that I just got paid on Friday. But there's something that's even greater that happened on Friday. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And that's what we are commissioned to do. We are commissioned to tell what Jesus had done for us. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. The Great Commission says in Matthew 28, verse 19 and 20, go ye therefore, teaching all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and go. And I will be with you always, even until the end of the world. God has told us and commissioned us to go throughout the earth and tell about what Jesus Christ has done for us on Calvary's cross. Since there is not one specific way on how to evangelize, these are tips and pointers in which we as Christians, and more specifically as disciples, are to effectively evangelize.
Yes.
First point is we must know the power of kindness. This is the main thing that we have to know as far as serving evangelism. We must be kind. Often the word evangelism brings to mind a dynamic person speaking to a large crowd about Jesus and giving an invitation for salvation.
Yes.
Some evangelists do speak to large crowds or public crowds, but the truth is there are many approaches to evangelism and many different strategies in which we are to evangelize. Servant evangelism is sharing God's love by simply serving others in a particular way without asking for or expecting anything in return. To get a complete understanding of what servant evangelism is, there's a story of a pastor by the name of Steve Jorgren, founding pastor of the church that grew from a handful to an average attendance of 7,500 every Sunday, amen? In just 15 years, he grew this church. Such things happen every now and then. We hear from about small church going to from small to a large amount of people every Sunday. But this is an unusual story because this happened in Cincinnati, Ohio, a city that has long been known for its in-your-face unfriendliness. Mark Twain spent a good deal of time in this city on the Ohio River and often commented about how rude the people were. When this church was launched in Cincinnati, Ohio, it was ranked the third most unfriendly city in America. But after serving about 12 million people over those 15 years, the tone of the city literally changed.
Yeah.
And that change had made a permanent impact on the city in the innumerable ways. Servant evangelism connects people to people in a natural, easy, low risk, and high grace way. Amen?
Amen.
The focus of servant evangelism is doing acts of kindness for anyone and everyone. As we have the opportunity, Galatians 6 and 10 says, let us do good to all people.
Hallelujah.
An example of serving evangelism can be something as simple as handing out free water bottles on a hot day, or taking bags of food to the needy families around Christmas time. The possibilities are endless, but the common denominator is that nothing is asked for in return. One of the motivations behind this type of evangelism is that the Bible tells us that God's kindness leads people to repentance. Amen?
Amen.
There are many benefits of serving evangelism, both for those served and for those serving. Serving evangelism reaches people where they are and exposes non-Christians to Christians, showing God's love in unmistakable and non-threatening ways. Not everyone is comfortable walking into a church building, amen? But receiving a free service with no strings attached is hard to resist. In fact, enabling them to hear and receive God into their hearts. It's a good way to water a seed previously sown, amen? Everyone has known or heard about the saying, one plants, one waters, but God gives the increase. And through this form of evangelism, it may be the first time that someone is hearing about Christ. And so through that act of kindness that you show, it can be good ground, amen, to sow a seed about what Jesus has done. For others, their seeds may already be planted. And through your act of kindness, it may show an opportunity to water or pour into someone that wants to know more about Christ. Serving evangelism benefits those serving as well. As Christians, we are called to be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you or give a reason for your hope or your faith in what you believe in. Serving others gives Christians the opportunity to tell about God's love. When someone asks why they're doing what they're doing or why you're doing what you're doing, you can point to Christ. It's a great training ground for other types of evangelism as well. Also, as Christians, we are to be full of the Holy Spirit, amen? In such a way that the Spirit flows out to others. Engaging in servant evangelism puts Christians in situations where the Holy Spirit can minister through them. Jesus commands his disciples and consequently all Christians today to go and make disciples of all nations, as it says in Matthew 28, verses 19 and 20. Jesus didn't say, wait inside your church building and wait for the lost to come to you. He said to go. Go ye therefore, amen?
Amen?
Through serving evangelism, the church can show people outside the church that God cares and gives them a reason to want to come inside. While serving evangelism is certainly a biblical practice, it is incomplete as a form of evangelism until the message of Jesus is spoken. Romans 10:17 tells us faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. To complete the process of evangelism to bring someone to accepting Christ as Savior, we need to speak the word about Jesus Christ. We can do all these nice things. We can give out water bottles. We can give away food. We can give away clothes. We can help at homeless shelters. We can do all these nice and kind things. But if we don't tell them that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. If we lack to tell them that God commended his love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. If we fail to tell them that who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree, that we being dead in sin should live unto righteousness. If we don't tell them that he was wounded for our transgression, that he was bruised for our iniquities, the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. If we fail to tell them that God, our Lord Savior Jesus Christ, died one Friday. But early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. We have failed our task. And everything that we have done, all the acts of kindness have been done in vain. Amen. Servant evangelism can be effective in opening a person's heart to receive the message once he or she has heard it. So speak. Speak the message. Amen. Don't serve them physically only, but serve them as well, spiritually as well. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, servant evangelism, servant evangelism. Hallelujah. We ought to be good witnesses for Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. At this time, I'm going to have our morning announcements by Sister Hart. Amen. With us this morning. We missed you last Sunday. Come on, let's stand down for Sister Hart as she gives us our morning announcements.
Over at Grace Temple on Tuesday evenings at 7 p.m. And the church is located at 7017 South Grandison. Okay? So get your glasses ready. Because you know they can put you in the back and drown them out if you don't even have a voice. But you can be up here, okay? So if you're interested in being in the choir, again, choir rehearsal will be on Tuesdays at 7 p.m. over at Grace Temple. Alrighty? Don't forget Wednesdays at 12 noon. Prayer and Bible study. So come out and get your prayer on. Wednesday afternoon. It's going to carry you through the week. Alrighty? Again, any announcements that you have that you want to have posted in the bulletin, make sure that you give that information to Sister Shannon so that she can get it in the bulletin for us. Okay? If you are interested in participating in the resource center, you need to see Sister Shannon because she is constantly working on that. And if you want to be a part of it, or if you have any ideas, because you may already have some information about supporting the resource center, get with Sister Shannon, okay?
Amen.
All right. There's an ongoing drive, of course, you know, for the clothing drive, which supports the church. So again, any donations that you may have, and make sure those items are in good condition, something that you want to give somebody that, you know, you may want to use yourself, make sure that they're in good condition. We will accept them. And if the person doesn't have a way to get into the church, we will make arrangements to pick them up for you, okay? Our upcoming events on April 24th, the Grace Temple family came out and supported us. They will be having a concert on April 24th. It's the King family, and it will be at Grace Temple. So, Cedar Grove family, we want to go out and support them. So, don't forget about that.
Hallelujah.
You have a flyer in your bulletin. Also, on April 15th, Grace Temple will also be having a fish fry, and that will be from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m., okay? So, let's go out and support their fish fry, just like they came over and supported our barbecue.
Amen.
We want to support their fish fry. So, thanks to the events, okay? So, Cedar Grove family, let's support. On May 7th, we have a pre-Mother's Day fundraiser here at Cedar Grove. So again, there's a bulletin that's been passed out. So again, we want to support that. Don't forget about it. We also have coming up in June, on June 4th, there will be a Cedar Grove chicken and fish fry. So keep all of these dates written down, posted on your calendars, on your iPhones, and all that other good stuff. That these are fundraisers and events that we want to support all of these items, okay? Don't forget about them. And you know about our own brother Mike for your media. So again, birthdays, anniversaries, whatever it is you need, see Brother Mike. Church CDs, see Brother Mike, okay? Children's room, we are still always accepting donations for that. So still accepting donations for those also. Dress down Sunday, you know that's always the fourth Sunday of every month, okay? As we go to our prayer list, we want to pray for Nita Nichols, Sister Ruth Bryan, Sister Jerea Gill, Elder Davis and family, Sister Katie Evans, Sister Linda Willis, Sister Janice Mitchell, Brother Bobby Collins and family, Sister Shannon Wilson, and we want to pray for the family of Sister Pat Smith. And he says, do you know what has happened since you went to bed last night? That you have been truly jealous because you got a pussy. But somebody didn't go to bed last night. But you got up this morning, so you feel blessed. 24 hours. And you can praise the Lord right now, because some of us might not be going to bed today.
Jesus, wash us clean of all
all our prices, yes, Lord. Because anything that's within us, Lord, that's not like you, we pray that you clean us out, God, in the name of Jesus. We pray that you fill us out with your Holy Spirit, God. Come in this place right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we pray for the praise. We pray for the prayer. Name on the prayer list, God. Sister Lenny Williams, Ruth Bryant, God. Drea Grill, Lord. Everybody on the prayer list, God. The Marie families, God. Sister Pat Smith's family, Lord. We pray right now in the name of Jesus that you touch these people, God. Touch these your people, God. In the mighty name of Jesus. We believe, God, that by your stripes we are healed, Lord. And we say thank you, Lord Jesus. We say thank you, Lord. We come right now, Lord Jesus, just glorifying you, Lord Jesus. Lifting you up, God. We're telling you, God, Lord Jesus, that you're wonderful, Lord. You've been so good to us, God. We praise your name. We shout hallelujah to your name, God. There's nobody like it, Lord Jesus. Nobody's good like you, God. No other friend that we know, Lord Jesus. We praise your name, God. We love you, Lord Jesus, today, God. We love you today, Lord Jesus. We pray right now that you come in right now in the name of Jesus. Move by your spirit, God. We come against the devil right now in the name of Jesus. Every trick, every trap that he has planted for City Grove family, God, we come against it now in the name of Jesus. Grow this your church, God. Lord, we pray right now for our vision, Lord Jesus. We pray for his vision, God. We clap our hands, Lord Jesus, in your sanctuary, God. We clap our hands, Lord Jesus, in your sanctuary, God. We clap our hands, Lord Jesus, in your sanctuary, God. We tell you thank you, Lord Jesus. And pray give us peace, God. Give us peace in our minds, God. Give our peace in our homes, God. Peace in our hearts, God. We pray right now, Lord Jesus, that you bless us, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Yeah.
now, amen. If you need the tithes and offering up below, please raise your hands high. That's just our coming to serve you. Amen. We have two methods of giving. You can give by check, write the check out to Cedar Grove Baptist Church. And lastly, you can give by cash. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We have all been commissioned. Amen. To give our tithe. Amen. A tenth of everything that we receive. Amen. Amen. If you need to tithe and offer, please raise your hands high. Serve me now. Amen. I believe that when you take care of the Lord's house,
that's it.
He will take care of your house. Do I have any witnesses
Amen.
Here?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Tithes and offering, Lord. Please raise your hands high. Amen.
So many wonderful things I've
good. I pray. Let the church say amen. Amen. God bless you and God keep you. And let's thank God for our first lady today. Show me what you do. Years of leadership, thank God for the Cedar Grove Baptist Church.
There. Jesus was there. See, here is water. What doth hinder me to be baptized?
believe this. Somebody says, I believe this. With all in heart, thou mayest. And he answered and said, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And he commanded the chariot to stand still. And they went down both into the water, both filled at the eunuch. And he baptized him. And when they come up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord called away Philip, that the eunuch saw him no more.
There is no God. But my brothers and
and sisters, I don't want to stop there at Kirk Cameron, because as a teenager, yes, he says he was an atheist, but at the age of 17, during the height of his career on the television show Growing Pains, Kirk Cameron met Jesus. I want somebody help me, somebody. Yes. He met Jesus and he became a born again believer. Tell somebody, say, there's still hope. All you got to do is plant the seed. They may not believe in it now, but you tell them, for God so loved the world that he came his only. I wish I had some help here. But God saw that he stood up. Believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. All you got to do is give them the good news and let the Holy Spirit do the rest. Let him do the rest. Kirk Cameron now is a strong believer for Christ. And he and his wife have opened up a camp for terminally ill children. And he is constantly involved in street witnessing. If you go to his website, he has different articles why he shares the gospel of Jesus Christ. He is considered a strong believer for Jesus. He left Growing Pains to go for Jesus. Y'all, that's what I just said. He left the show to go for the Savior. He left TV to go for somebody who's able to turn your life around. Yes, my brothers and sisters, he's a strong believer. He's a strong witness for Jesus Christ. And here in our text for today's consideration, we find a fellow by the name of Philip. Somebody shout Philip. Can you shout Philip's name again? Yeah. Philip, a deacon in the Lord's church, sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. You know, we started it last week on both locations. Our sermon presentation for the month of, April is evangelism. And here in our text, my brothers and sisters, we find a fellow by the name of Philip, a deacon in the Lord's church, sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Somebody shout Philip for me. Philip, an ordinary man sharing the gospel. Philip, a man of honest report. Philip, a man full of the Holy Ghost. Philip, a man of wisdom. Philip, a man who was on fire for the Lord. Here in the text, he shows us that he was a willing witness for the Lord. And I think I need to pause here parenthetically and tell you, my brothers and sisters, as I said on last week, you don't have to have a title to be a witness. I only got about 5 or 6 facts, man. You don't have to have the name Reverend so-and-so. You don't have to be a minister so-and-so. You don't have to be a pastor so-and-so. You don't have to be a preacher, doctor, pope, bishop, overseer. Come on, help me. Supervisor so-and-so. All you have to be is a born-again believer. Can I get a witness here? Touch somebody and say, just be born again. Because who can't tell me about Jesus if you don't know Jesus? You can't tell me that Jesus saves if you're not saved. Can I get a witness here? But if you know Jesus, what you're going there for, come on, talk back to me. And teach all nations, Lord, help me preach, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them, Lord, help me to observe things whatsoever I command you. And come to your neighbor and say, Lo. Come on, tell them, Lo. I'm with you always, even to the end of the earth. See, I only got about 3 folks walking with me. That's because
cause. Yeah, some of us don't want to witness. But baby, can I tell you, he's commissioned, he's commanded for you and I to go tell the world about him. Can I get a witness here? So my brothers and sisters, I got about 17 minutes on the clock. Philip here shows us how to witness to those who are the least lonely and the left out. Y'all miss me. He shows us, Paul, how to witness to those who are the least, the lonely, and the left out. Here it is, number one, write this down. Philip shows us, if you're going to witness, you got to have a burden for the lost. I think I said that last week, but I didn't get to it in grace. So here's a good point to tell you. If we're going to do some witnessing, and I don't in the street, but in our house. Come on, help me here. Not only in our house, but in our job. And I think I need to throw this in for free. Don't try to witness to my house if you're not witnessing in your own house. Don't try to chastise my child if you won't chastise your own. Y'all ain't saying that to me. But don't try to correct my children if your children are there to the food. Yet witnessing evangelism, it stopped at home. Can I get a witness? Yes, you got to have a burden. Somebody shout burden. Yeah, you got to have a burden. You got to have a burden. You got to have a burden. You got to have a burden to witness. Our story begins. We see Philip, a Jewish man who would have been raised with natural prejudice against Samaritans. But the Bible says that he goes to Samaria and ministers to the people. Y'all not miss, y'all feeling me, y'all not feeling me. Acts chapter 8, Lord have me preach. Acts chapter 8, verse 5 and 6 says that Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ to them. And the people with one accord listened to what Philip was saying. Y'all got to understand that Philip overcame any hang-ups he had about the Samaritans. You got to understand that the Samaritans and Jews didn't get along, and so Philip put all of that stuff aside. But whenever you meet Jesus, you'll put your hang-ups aside. You'll put your prejudice aside. You'll put your cultural difference aside to make sure that somebody gets to know Jesus. Come here and even ask him, do you know him? No, come on, ask him, do you know him? How did they respond? If you know him, you ought to clap. If you know him, you ought to say amen. If you know him, you ought to jump. If you know him, you ought to do something. For the Bible says, let the redeemer of the Lord say so. Before I go to my next point, I think I need to tell you that we've got to stop allowing prejudice, and our racial barriers to keep us from spreading the gospel. They may not look like us. They may not sing like us. They may not smell like us. But the gospel is for everybody. Y'all ain't saying nothing. The gospel is for everybody. For everybody. It's for the white man, the black man, the brown man, the red man. It's for Jew, Gentile, Greek. It's for everybody. It's for folk in Beverly Hills and also for folk in the ghetto. It's for everybody. It's for those who are living in apartments, those who are living in mansions, and those who live it on the street. It's for everybody. It's for anybody who's eating a steak. It's for anybody who's eating chicken. And it's for anybody who's eating pork and beans. It's for everybody. Pump your neighbor, it's for everybody. Put your prejudice aside. You ain't been all that. Jesus died for humanity. He didn't just die for you. He didn't just die for your cousin. He didn't just die for your child. But the Bible says said he sold out the world. God, help me preach. Bump your neighbor and tell him we got a witness to everybody. That's the wrong one. Tell somebody and say we got a witness to everybody. God, help me preach. I got 12 inch number two. Philip went to where people were. Can you write that down somewhere? Philip went to where people were. Philip, somebody shout Philip. Where people were. We too, my brothers and sisters, have to go where people are. The Bible does not teach that the whole world should go to the church, but rather that the church should go to the whole world. See, we want to come in here with our falling no more. Sing Zion songs and go home feeling good. But baby, can I tell y'all something? We got to take that gospel to the street. Y'all didn't hear me. We're going to come up in here and have a good time, run around the room, shout, dance. But then when we go out there, we don't want to tell nobody about Jesus. But baby, let me tell you, in here we come to learn. In here we come to be taught. Here we come to get information, and here we come to get inspiration. And when we get our inspiration, we get up off our lady behind and go out into the street and tell somebody, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, shall believe in thy heart that God has raised on his name. I said we gotta go to where they are. Can you find somebody and say, go to where they are? We got to go to the prostitute. We got to go to the pimp. We got to go to the dope dealer. We got to go to marijuana sinners. We got to go to the streets. We got to go to the alcoholic. We got to go to the backbiter. We got to go to the fornicator. We got to go to the adulterer. We got to go to the liar. We got to go to the sinner. Call it sinner.
Is that a blood?
Don't tell me, but tell them, tell somebody about Jesus. I didn't mean to do all of it. I woke up this morning, I didn't feel it. But I told my mom, if you just let me get to the pulpit, if you just let me plant my feet behind the sacred tent, I said, Lord, if you just let me open my mouth, I'll tell somebody, he able to save you.
Somebody talk to me.
What is in the desert? It's dry.
Put your fire to everything on your
your heart.